coming home late night. I've been sleeping past daylight. I'm waking up, you're not by my side. Baby, that ain't right. I wanna be there with you. I really do be missing you. Everything I do is.
Hey guys, it's Yellow Baby back with another video. And today I'm going to be doing a what's in my hospital bag and my baby's hospital bag. I know, I'm sorry, I've been gone for so long. I really wanted to stay consistent, but it's been hard. Like, I've been really lazy. I just want to be in bed. And I'm 38 weeks. I have 9 days to my due date. Like, oh, I'm sorry about the sound. I'm gonna tell you guys from now because my sound is horrible. Like, my sound goes up and down, up and down. I don't know why. Like, that's why I haven't posted my other video, my haul, the second part, because when I filmed it, my sound was horrible and it kept going in and out, in and out. And I don't want to post bad quality videos, but I've been trying to fix it and it does not want to work. I don't know how I'm gonna fix it. I've looked for videos on how to fix it. I've done everything and I still can't find a way to fix it. I think I'm gonna have to get like a mic or something, or use headphones or something. But I'm just trying to get a video out for y'all. I just want y'all to see that I want to be consistent, even though I've tried and I haven't been. It's just really hard when you're pregnant. I'm gonna try harder. But anyways, let's just get into the video. So I'm gonna start with my baby's diaper bag. This is the diaper bag that I got for her, and I'm gonna use it for the hospital bag because why not? I already have it. So I'm gonna show you guys what I packed in her bag. And I just wanna say, you know, I'm a first time mom and I didn't wanna go overboard with what I was bringing to the hospital, but I wanted to bring like what was necessary, especially now with COVID. I don't really know what they give you, what they don't give you. I've never been in this situation. Like, I've never had a baby before, so I don't know what they give you at the hospital. And I just brought like a couple of things that I might need, and I don't think I went overboard. I think I packed like a good amount of stuff and things that are necessary, you know. But yeah, let's get into this video. I just wanted to put that out there. So in her bag, I packed a bib, just one, because just in case. I don't know if she's gonna need it, but I just packed it just in case. Like when we're going on our way home or something, or just in case. It says all we need is love. I also packed this little thing for her pacifier. I just packed it because I wanna put it on her pacifier, so yeah. Probably when I get out, when I'm leaving the hospital, because I'm not gonna be thinking about this after I give birth. I'm gonna show you guys the outfits. I brought just a little sleeper. I brought one. This is how it looks. It's newborn. And I got it at Target. It came in a pack. It says happy little smiles with a little bunny on it. So yeah, that's the one. And everything is washed already. I washed all her clothes, like literally all her clothes. So yeah, I'm bringing that. And to go with that, I'm bringing this little hat and the mittens that go with it. And just in case I want to take a cute picture with a bow, I'm just bringing a pink bow that's the same color. The second outfit is some little pants. I have a little ruffle on the back. And this is newborn. And this is just a long sleeve newborn onesie. Long sleeve onesie. And it has the little hand things on it. So I didn't put mittens with this outfit because it has the little hand thingies. And to go with that, I put this little bow. and these little socks, and also a little sweater. This is newborn. I got it at Target. And yeah, just in case, you know. This is just an extra outfit, basically. And I brought a 0 to 3 white onesie, just in case, you know, she doesn't fit the newborn one. So I'm just bringing it as extra. And her going home outfit is a tradition in my country to take the baby out, like, to bring them home from the hospital, to wear yellow. And they do these knitted outfits for them. And my mom brought it from Dior. As you can see, it's light yellow. I don't know if I can see, okay. Yeah, now you see. She got it in a size 1 month. Hopefully it fits her. But yeah, these are the little pants. I also brought another newborn onesie. This is short sleeve to go under the little sweater that I'm about to show you guys. To go under this little sweater. It's really cute. And yeah, that's her going home outfit. It comes with this little, I don't know if it's bonnet style hat. I don't know if that's how you call it, but it comes with that. And I just got these white socks and white mittens. I'm also bringing an extra little beanie and the mittens that go with it, just in case. So it's just three outfits. That's it. And I'm bringing a swaddle. That's what I'm going to be using to take a picture of her. I don't know why I'm talking like that. Like, I feel slow. I'm bringing a blanket. It's just this knitted blanket that my mom bought with that outfit. And it has a bow right here. It's like this. It's just a blanket. And I'm just bringing it because, you know, I'm gonna need a blanket for when I leave the hospital. So I'm bringing this one because, you know, her outfit to leave the hospital is the yellow one. So I was like, let me just take the blanket because mom got it. So yeah, so that was what was in the big pocket. So now moving on to the front pocket. My mother told me that I should bring some diapers just in case. Like, I told her they give you diapers there, but she's like, bring it just in case, just bring some. So I packed me some newborn diapers. And I also packed some wipes, just in case. And the last thing is in the little pouch, which is a pacifier. I sterilized it, so I put it in this plastic Ziploc bag. It's just the Itsy Ritsy one. I'm not taking it out because I sterilized it, so I don't want to dirty it. That's what I packed in her hospital bag. So now we're moving on to mine. So this is my hospital bag. It's just a Victoria's Secret one. Okay, first things first, I got me some slippers. I went to Old Navy and got me some slippers. They're like $5. And I just need them to get in the shower because I'm not putting my feet in that dirty hospital shower. So I got me some slippers. I'm also bringing an extra bag because somebody told me to take everything that they give you because is there for you. So I'm bringing me diapers and everything they give me home. So I brought me an extra bag for that. So I packed these little bags with my necessities, and I'm gonna show you guys what's in here. This one, I have a bonnet. I'm gonna do my hair, so it's gonna be straightened, and I'll probably put it in a bonnet because I don't want it to be in my face. I'm bringing a portable charger. I think I have to charge it, I'm not sure, so I'm gonna leave it out and charge it now. But I'm bringing that because I heard that the plugs are really far, and yeah, so I'm just bringing my portable. I'm also bringing these soothy gel pads for your nipples, you know, because they're gonna be sore. So I'm bringing them just in case. I don't know if I'm gonna be using them, but I'm bringing it. I bought me some nursing pads because I'm gonna be leaking. Then I brought me these two samples of nipple cream. If I end up liking it, I'm gonna buy it. I know they give you more at the hospital, so that's why I haven't bought any. Hopefully they do give it to me, I don't know. I'm bringing an extra mask, just in case. It's washed, so. And in this little pouch, I'm bringing some hair ties and some bobby pins. So that's what's in that bag. And the next bag, I got my toiletries. I have a soap because I don't want to use the soap in the hospital, so I got my own. I also have a toothbrush and toothpaste in here. I bought extra ones just in case, but yeah. I just have my toothbrush and toothpaste. Bought a mini loofah because I don't want to bring my big one, so I just bought this mini one. Brought me some Dove cream lotion. I'm also bringing my deodorant. Just got me a travel size one. I'm bringing some mouthwash because why not. I'm bringing some lip balm for my lips because I know my lips are gonna be dry. I'm bringing some tissues, just a little pack of tissues. I don't know why, but I'm bringing it. Some hand sanitizer, cause you know what we in right now. And just a Ziploc bag so I can put my wet loofah in here because I don't want nothing to get wet in here. So I'm just bringing this. And that's what's in this bag. So moving on to the clothes and stuff. Well, I got me these discreet boutique things from Always. They're like diapers and pads at the same time. They look like this. And yeah. So I got me these, and because I know I'm gonna be bleeding. Well, they say you bleed after you give birth for a while, so bring me four of these. I know they give you some, but I heard these are really comfortable, and a lot of people on TikTok recommend them, so since I'm be on there, just got me these. So I'm also bringing me just three granny panties, you know. That's what I'm going to be using now. And I brought me this, just one of these shapers, like it holds like the bottom of your belly down, so I really wanted one of these, so I got me this. I have three of them. It came three in a pack, and these were, I got them at Marshall's, and these were $9.99, so yeah, I got me a three pack, and I'm just bringing one. I know these are gonna be good for when I wear the diapers because, you know, I want something to hold it down, so I'm gonna be wearing those. Next thing I got, well, I went to Marshall's and I got me this sports bra. They're very comfortable and they're mad big. Like, I really did not know that I was gonna get this big, but yeah. These are a 2X, and I was like, Mom, like, I don't want to get some big ass some big ass freaking bra or what? And then she said my boobs are gonna get really big because the milk, so I had to like get something that I can make, well, that has space for me to grow into it. So I got them in a 2x. So I'm just bringing one of those. It came with two in a pack, and those were $15 from Marshalls. I'm bringing just two pairs of socks, some low socks, ankle socks, and a pair of long socks, just in case. I know my feet get cold, so I just bought three pairs of socks. I'm bringing my own towel because I do not want to use their towels. My going home outfit is going to be these sweats. This polo shirt is just a t-shirt. My sweater that goes with these sweats. So that's what I'm wearing to go home. I'm bringing these pajamas. I might bring these because I'm going out to see if I could find some better ones, because the top, like, I don't know, I just want something like loose. The top is not as loose on me, and I know my stomach's gonna go down, but the top is not as loose on me, so I might go out and get a new one. Get another one if I have time, but if not, then I'm gonna end up just wearing these. But this is just the pants. They're just long pants, and they're purple with white, and they have flowers. And this is the shirt. It's a button-up shirt because, you know, I want to be easy accessible for when I'm breastfeeding. And this is my robe. It's just purple. It's just a simple robe. And I'm just bringing a tank top just in case I don't want to wear that shirt. I was like, let me just pack a tank top. It's just a regular tank top. And I just brought me a little bag to put my dirty clothes into because I don't want to put them with my clean clothes. And yeah, that's what's in there. I also have to pack my wallet with my ID, my insurance, and some money in there for the vending machines just in case I get hungry. And I also have to pack 2 WIC forms because they want one for me and for the baby. They have to fill it out at the hospital, so I gotta bring 2 copies of those. And that's it, basically. I don't think I have to bring anything else. So guys, that's what's in my baby's and my hospital bag. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and got like a little idea on what to pack. Like I said, I'm a first-time mom. I just packed what I thought I needed because I've been watching YouTube videos on what I need to pack, and I just got an idea out of that. And that's it, basically. That's all I packed, and we're ready. I just gotta grab my bags and go in the car seat, of course. Can't forget that. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed. I hope you guys keep supporting me. I'm sorry I've been slacking. I'm gonna try to make it better, and I don't know how that's gonna work when the baby's here, but I promise you guys I'm going to be making videos. I do want to film a labor and delivery vlog. Hopefully I get to film it because if I'm in pain, I don't know how that's going to work, but we'll see. And yeah, just stay tuned. My room transformation video is coming soon. As you guys can see, my room is painted. Don't mind that you see my lights reflect onto the walls, so that's why it looks like that. But my room transformation video is coming soon. Well, my room tour in depth, whatever, is coming soon. I'm just trying to finish some stuff. I'm pretty sure I'm done, but no, I have some stuff coming in the mail. So Yeah. Let me stop filming. This video is already probably long, but I'll see you guys in my next video. Stay tuned. Keep supporting. Comment down below what you guys want to see. Like this video and subscribe to my channel, please. Thank you guys for watching. Stay blessed and stay happy. I love you guys.